Good morning, everybody. For the last couple of months, I've been shuffling a whole bunch of boxes up here to Alaska. Supplies for the cabin, things that I'll need in the future, and things that I can use right now. But every time I would go to Home Depot, I would just spend an extra $120, $140 on extra parts and pieces just for future projects that are going to be going on up here. And so right now, we're going to kind of go through a little unboxing of all the stuff that I've sent up. And I'll go ahead and zoom in for that, or I'll show you all that. So I got a stove, and then I've been shuffling up these boxes through the mail system. So we're going to go ahead and do an unboxing right now. And I just kind of want to show you guys some of the supplies that I've been shipping up here. And some of it's spices and food-related items. Most of them are probably tools, though. But to be honest with you, I've been doing this for about 4 or 5 months now, and I don't remember everything that I kept cramming in these boxes, sending it up. So it's going to be kind of like Christmas. So as I open up each box, I'm going to remember and remember what I sent up and why I sent it up. And so just things to have for the cabin. Alright, this is the spice box. I remember this one. Okay, so in this box, an old flag that needs to be mended. Save that. So that'll be some needle or stitch work. Toothbrushes. Bouillon cubes, both chicken and beef. Got three of those each, so when I do go to cook, always nice to have that. Like I said, this whole box right here is basically stuff for the kitchen. Extra band-aids, big band-aids, dental floss, gotta have it, guys. Big bottle of aspirin, two tubes of toothpaste, which is Tom's. Non-fluoride, all that good stuff. Gotta have the toothpaste, guys. A Zippo lighter and a little pouch. Alright, glad that's up here. Okay. Some ibuprofen. Some acetaminophen. Vitamin C. Garlic salt. Gotta have the garlic salt. Some bandage tape. Waterproof bandage tape, so that would go in the first aid section. Two packs of Goody's headache powder, gotta have it. Can of baking powder. Celery salt. Onion powder. Tylenol, extra strength. So, let's see, a little bottle of Neosporin. Garlic salt again, some more vitamins, vitamin E, 400 IU, soft shells, nice. Lemon pepper, fish oil, 1200 milligram little tablets. Once again, that goes in the first aid section. Lowry's seasoning salt, and another bottle of acetaminophen. All right. Couple packs of dry yeast for cooking, making bread, biscuits, things of that nature. Some ball canning lids. Some large sterilized gauze pads. So I'm kind of trying to build up the first aid kit. I already have a bunch of first aid stuff up here. Two tubes of chapstick. I already have 8 up here. Now I have 2 more. Add those to the pile. A little strap for your sunglasses. Keep those on your head so you don't lose them. And looks like just a few little nuts and bolts. How I even threw these in the box, I have no clue, but that's kind of funny. Okay. That is it for box number 1. Box number two. And some of these boxes, guys, by the way, weigh about 45, 50 pounds. I know they don't look like it, but trust me, I packed some of these like you would not believe. Wow. Okay. A scrub brush for the sink when you're doing dishes. Little bags to hold various things. Pack of razors that I'll probably never use up here. In Alaska, it's bad manners to shave. You just grow it out, get the whole mountain man thing going. But I have them in case I need it. Pack of Irish Spring soap. Gotta have it. I already have soap up here. A toothbrush holder. Put your toothbrush in there. Good to go. Two big jumbo boxes of matches. Strike Anywhere matches. I'll take them. Oregano. Gotta have it. Put that in the food. Okay. Two computer fans. I'm gonna mount these onto a solar array, and that solar array is gonna drive these fans to push hot air in here. I'm gonna make a solar heater that I attach to the outside of the cabin. That's what this is for. That's a project for down the road. I'll cross that bridge when I get to it. I started buying a bunch of these these metal-coated hooks to hang chainsaws and whatnot from the ceiling and the rafters, and just anything else that I want to hang, heavy pieces of equipment, tools, etc., etc. So every time I'd go to the store, it seems like I'd always pick up a few of these things. So right here, I got five of them. Door hinges. Gotta have door hinges. Once again, future project for a door that I might or might not be hanging. A depth gauge file from a chainsaw helps you file down your rakers so the blades work more efficiently. A pack of Diablo cutting blades, Sawzall cutting blades. Let's see. There's six of them in here. This was actually a great deal at Home Depot, guys. Not a sponsor for Home Depot, by the way. Or I'm not sponsored by them. Two Diablo blades. And these are the 7 1/4 inch blades, 24 teeth, basically ripping teeth. This is an Echo blade. This goes on your weed eater. These things right here, guys, for cutting brush, absolutely amazing. Take off your weed eater head, install this thing, and it's like a metal disc that just rips apart anything that you put in front of it. I have literally mowed down about 1.25 acres of Alaskan bush with one of these. Every time I go to Home Depot, I just have this thing about buying another one. I've already got three of them up here. Can't have too much. All right. Wrenches. Gotta have wrenches, guys. Big boy, little guys, wire cutters, needle nose pliers, just various tiny little tools. Eventually you will need them. I already have a bunch of tools up here, but you always need more. All right. Crushed red pepper, Zatarain's cayenne pepper, and garlic powder. Pile is growing. Another pack of door hinges, small ones. Two latches for doors or whatnot. Basically, you can see that. Okay. Let's see. Various little bags. I'm going to adjust the camera real quick, guys. Various little bags. That may be a little too hot. Sorry. Little bag of finishing nails, a little bag of nuts and bolts, and little screws you can put in the wall. That goes in the tool pile. A triple charger. It's a USB charger. So you plug that into a computer or a USB outlet, and it's got a tri-charger on it. Apple, iPhone, Samsung. Basically, we do have a solar charger up here on the window. Plugs into the USB port on the solar charger. And depending on what phone you have, well, you now have the ability to charge it, trickle charge it anyway. So there's that. Extra boot laces. Gotta have them. Eye drops. A surge protector. A real thick, heavy bag of nuts, bolts, little mounting plates, washers, and L brackets, little tiny L brackets. Batteries, C's, can't have enough of them, guys. I only run some things up here off batteries. I do have a generator that's going to be taking over all that function now, but headlamps, little portable lights like this, it's kind of what I've been using so far. They've worked good, so obviously you need batteries. And surprisingly, I have two of those lights. They don't chew up the batteries at all. I mean, the batteries that are still working this year were in there last year. So that's a good thing. A big bag of, looks like, 3.5 inch screws. Long screws, good ones. Another fan. Computer fan for a future project that I'll show you guys. A couple patches that I'm gonna have I'll probably do it. Go ahead and put this on some of my coats or jackets or snow pants just as a decoration. I just threw them in the box to have them, got them out of my way. Two little neodymium magnets. Apparently not that good, but this has a purpose too. That's another project I'll take you guys along for. Out here, you have to be kind of ingenious with what you do have. All right, box number two is done. Moving on to three. And like I said, guys, this is all just stuff that I have shipped up here just so I can have it. Most of it is not needed for right now, but once you have it, you have it. There is no Home Depot out here, guys. I am 70 miles from the nearest town. I am in the middle of the Alaskan Range. There's nothing out here. No roads, no running water, except the rivers and creeks. Not now, because they're frozen solid. Those are our highways. But you're on your own out here. So all the stuff I'm bringing, what little medicine I do have, things of that nature, it all comes in handy. May not be right now, but at least you have them. And that is the important thing out here. All right. Bosch blades. Drilling blades. Another pack of D batteries. The big boys. And like I said, I would just constantly go to Home Depot. And I would always spend, you know, whatever it was I was doing or buying. And then I would spend an extra $110, $120 bucks on just miscellaneous stuff. Things that I think that I would need. There. Oh, that is not good. Okay, the Postal Service, if you're watching, handle my packages better next time. A 1950s buck knife. This was my grandfather's. Gave it to my father. My father gave it to me. My grandfather purchased this in 1953, I believe. And it is a buck 119 with the original case. So if any of you guys know any history about these buck knives with the black onyx handle and the silver tip on it, let me know. Put that down below in the comments. Would love to hear it. Self-explanatory. Big boy. This is for hauling trees on my snow machine, pulling things over with ropes. I've got tree savers. This would obviously go to it, hook a chain up to it. Pretty self-explanatory. All right, three of these. So I've been going to Home Depot, buying these little multi-packs of screwdriver heads, flat heads, star heads, hex bits, the whole deal. There's that one. That one. That one. Milwaukee drill bits. Always need the drill bits out here. You always have to be drilling pilot holes for something. It seems like everything I do out here demands giant screws and bolts, and when you just try to drive one of those straight into something, you know how hard and what a pain in the butt all that is. Two more Diablo skill saw blades. An angle finder. Well, when I start cutting boards, projects of that nature, it's basically an angle finder. Got to have one of these if you want to do any type of woodworking out here with angles, especially when you're going to be building something. And pretty shortly, I will be building enough things, at least during the summer months, when I can get my woodshed in, an outhouse in, an outbuilding for tools, and all this stuff, so I can get it outside the cabin. Very valuable tool. Channel locks. These guys right here, that guy right there, big boy. Like I said, guys, just miscellaneous tools and stuff. Another pair of channel locks, little needle nose channel locks. It may not be called channel locks, sorry. I'm just running through this real fast. Okay, very important out here, lifting heavy loads. Huge pulley. This thing is a giant one, this snatch block. This is rated for 17,600 pounds. Obviously, I'll never hoist or lift or pull something like that, but by the big boys, so at least you got it. And by quality ones. There's a lot of cheap snatch blocks out there. If you're gonna do it, just spend the extra $8 and get the better one. A little multi-tool. Probably never use that, but nevertheless, I have it. Handy little pouch. Two erroneous spikes. Don't ask me where those came from. Porter cable for drilling holes. And wood, obviously. Attach that to your drill. Start punching through wood. Make your holes. And look at here, surprise, surprise, another blade that goes on my weed eater. This is just a different tooth configuration. Flints for my Zippo lighters. I have backups to my backups to my backups when it comes to lighting utensils out here. A little pack of mounting plates. Little guys and the big guys. So if I want to join or marry something together, I've got the plates to do it now. Giant mounting plates. Pretty self-explanatory. Same thing as what I just showed you, just much bigger. Now this was just laying around in the house and I figured it would come in useful for something. Pretty self-explanatory. An extremely cheap knife, a little bag of washers, a few nuts and bolts in there. This big bolt, I have no use for this whatsoever. There was room in the box, so I just threw it in there. And then I got that guy right there for hanging, pulling, whatever. Spring, don't ask. It was just laying around. I threw it in the box. If you don't have it, you can't use it. And there's no Home Depot out here. Did I already say that? Next box. Back. bags, Ziploc bags, and a whole bunch more inside here. Another scrubbing utensil for the dishes. Backups to your backups out here, guys. Something breaks, if you can't fix it and you don't have a replacement, you're not getting a new one. Screwdrivers, gotta have them. So I'm starting to build my tool collection out here as well. Once I get all this put up and hung up and whatnot, I'll go through and show you all the tools that I've had to haul out here. But there's three long screwdrivers, pack of Gorilla tape, duct tape, call it what you want, gotta have it. Pretty self-explanatory, guys. Another cooking utensil. These little metal rods right here. I do have a purpose for these, but once again, it's just one of those things that was laying around in the garage back home. So I figured one day these will come in handy or useful somewhere, somehow. So I figured I would throw them in there. Like I said, guys, not everything coming out of these boxes has a purpose now, but eventually you will have a need for it. Another long screwdriver. This is for hinges onto a door. You slide a 2x4 through them. Bolt these to the wall. Slide a 2x4. You keep that door from bears, grizzlies, black bears, or from something just ripping your door completely off. Out here, that's very important. There's huge bears out here. Everybody has a story about going hunting. Well, I don't have to go anywhere. I just go right out front, and they are literally walking by here during the summertime regularly. Moose during the wintertime, which it is right now, constantly walking right and back and forth across this property. The animals are here. So big hardware to keep things secure and shut is absolutely necessary. Once again, I do not have a use for it right now, but I will. Whether it be on a smokehouse door, storage, or whatever. Looks like another DeWalt screwdriver set. X heads, star bits. Can't have enough tools. Little bottle of Gorilla Glue. Gotta have it. Okay, these are just mounting plates. They go with those metal rods. Alright, L brackets for shelves and to sturdy things up. These are corner braces, not L brackets, excuse me. Bag of corner braces, L brackets, corner braces again, smaller L braces, corner braces, another bag of bigger braces. A hinge, door hinge. A large one. Five little bags, six little bags, seven little bags of various size screws, nuts, bolts. An entire screwdriver set. This goes with the long ones. Sorry, I'm not showing you each one, but the screwdrivers, you don't need to see all that. But screwdrivers, different sizes and lengths. More screwdrivers, sizes and lengths. A latch, a door pull, not a latch, but a door handle. Gotta have it. When I build the door, obviously you need a handle. Another door hinge, large size. More corner braces. L brackets, corner braces. I guess they are different, but same thing. Another little bag of screws, different size. And of course, five more screwdrivers, various sizes and lengths. I'm good on screwdrivers. Spikes for when I go to build out here. Out here, everything is larger than life. You use certain types of nails and whatnot, but if you're building something, a building, or an outhouse, or a shed, or something, and you're using trees, 12-inch spike. And then I bought his cousin the 8-inch spike. Got a whole bunch of them. No use for them right now, but I will have a use for them. More long nails, except these have a twist in them, if you can see that. Oh, about 10 of them right there, or whatever that number is. Writing pens. Gotta have them. Common nails, 20D. I'm just trying to build up my stores of all my building materials and just things that I will eventually need. I keep saying that, I know, but it all will come in very handy one day. So, 16D common nails. Exterior screws, 2.5 inches. 16D, 3.5 common nails. A box of AAAs, 24 of them. Pretty self-explanatory. AAA batteries inside here. Batteries so far have been working great out here. These little guys go in all our headlamps. As soon as the sun goes down out here, yes, you can have lights going on in here, but you're constantly going somewhere and you need your headlamp on. And when the headlamps start getting dim, it starts getting dark real quick. Batteries are a good thing out here for various little functions. Couple little multi-tools. Don't even ask me what this thing is. I don't know. More screws, a little bag of screws. Next box. Oh yeah, very important this one, guys. Self-explanatory. You get your snow machine stuck out here, get your ATV stuck out here. Obviously, one side goes to the stuck machine. The other side goes to the machine or whatever's going to pull you out, whether it be a come-along or whatnot. And you can also use this in conjunction with this. You'll figure it out. Stuff like this out here is gold. You always have this on your snow machine. Or some sort of tow rope. Q-tips. Pretty self-explanatory. Big boy flashlight. Another scrubbing utensil. Seem to be racking up those scrubbing utensils. Coffee cup. I have a name. I'm not going to bring that up. I have a nickname. I'm not telling it on camera. I don't want people putting stuff down in the comments of that. I'm going to let that one go. This is gold right here. Guys, I got to show you this. When it comes to honey production in America now, welcome to the FDA and government rules and regulations and all that junk and garbage. When you go to the grocery store to buy honey, an average bottle of honey is going to run you anywhere from $2 to $6, depending on what brand you get. But that is all filtered, heat treated, etc., etc., etc. The raw, unfiltered honey, this stuff is just straight from the hive. $14 a bottle. Nature Nate's, $14 a bottle. I got 2 bottles. All the healing properties of this stuff are just absolutely amazing. There's some other channels on YouTube. You can check this stuff out. But raw honey is amazing for your body and your overall health. All right, a crushed tin with some bug spray repellent. Wow, they really did crush this one. Just a little tin. and then lemon eucalyptus spray, and then a bottle of Zippo lighter fluid. Gotta have that for the Zippos, guys. Another little tin. Aleve. Go ahead and put that in the medicines. Old Bay seasoning, guys. I am from the South. I love my seasoning, love my crab boils, whole deal. No, there are crabs up here, but they're 70 miles that way. But nevertheless, I have the seasoning for it when I do get the crabs up here. Not like that, though, guys. The crabs out of the ocean. Black pepper. More yeast for baking bread, biscuits, etc., etc. Weichmann's Active Dry Yeast. And all this stuff has a long shelf life, too. It's all good till 2019. So as I was buying the stuff in the store, especially the food and the aspirin and whatnot, I was checking the expiration dates on all of it to make sure that it was at least 2 years out before manufacturer says that it's no good or best buy date. Those are two different things. That box is now empty. I got these little tins. Obviously this one right here is going to need some work. Thank you very much, Postal Service, for destroying my 7-cent tin. I want to be reimbursed. Fat chance on that one, right? Mm-hmm. Another 250 count box of matches. You can never have enough matches out here, guys. Latex gloves for painting and other various chores. You may be cutting up an animal, whatever you need a latex glove for. Well, I've now got them. I got two packs. Extra boot laces once again. Ball canning jar lids, two packs. I think we've seen this story. Nuts, spikes. Huge spikes. For future projects. More long nails, spikes, call them what you want. Guess it depends what part of the country you're in for that one. These come in very useful out here for a lot of reasons. And I got a bunch of these. Another box of 2.5-inch exterior screws. Big boy box, 20D 4-inch nails. Two boxes of 1.5-inch fence staples. When I build my garden, I'm obviously going to put up the wire fence. These are going to staple it to the posts. Two boxes of 1.5-inch. 2.5-inch exterior screws, 1.5-inch fence staples, once again. Another box, 1.5-inch fence staples, 8-inch giant spikes, nails, whatever. I'm going to put metal roofs on everything out here, on all my buildings. I now have 10 snips. One cuts right, one cuts left, one cuts straight. You have to have it if you're going to be working with metal. Alright, tea plates. A box of tea plates for when I build certain furniture. Flat corner braces. Another box of tea plates. Flat corner braces. Flat corner braces. Two boxes of big corner braces. The big boys. Door hinges. Here, I'm just going to show you one of each. Door hinges. But I got 5 of this one, 6 of this one. Another hinge. Real big boy hinges. Two Home Depot pencils. And once again, anchor shackles. And got it. All right, that wipes out that box. Moving on. Now I sent this up during Christmas time. This was a little present to myself. Obviously, out here in the bush, you can run a generator. I do have a generator, but you gotta cut yourself from the cord, guys. These new power tools are unbelievable. They're awesome. 7 1/4 rigid circular saw. Brand new, never used. Can't wait to try this baby out, especially with all my Diablo blades. Cut the cord, guys. Start going cordless. These battery systems, doesn't matter what you go with, Milwaukee, DeWalt, Rigid, Makita, they've all caught up. These tools are incredible, especially for out here. If you don't have a generator or whatnot, and you do have a couple battery packs, you're good to go, man. It's not going to stop you from getting a project completed or what have you. Now, I've read all the reviews on the blade that Rigid sends with its circular saw. Everybody says it's garbage. And in every YouTube video that I've watched of these power tools, they all have Diablo blades in them. Batteries, backups to your backups. And these are the 18 volt, and let's see, these are the 4 amp hours. These things were $99 a piece. The damn circular saw was $139. Go figure, they get you on the batteries, guys. But you already knew that. This is gonna come in so handy. That box is now done. And last but not least, and I am proud of this one, I now have a stove. It is the Martin one. There are basically two stoves that you can buy, guys. It's either the Camp Chef model or it's the Martin. The Martin is just a little bit bigger, a little longer, a little taller, and I read all the reviews on them. This one just, plus it's made in Canada. Camp Chef, pretty sure it's made in China. So those are your options. You can go with the old Coleman stoves, you can go with a Martin or a Camp Chef. I have seen a number of Camp Chef reviews. They look like great little stoves, but out here I don't want to play around. This one's just a little bit bigger and it was about the same price. But it did cost me $102.65 to ship this up here. Yeah, what's another $100, right? Guys, I know this video is running long. This will be my long video. But I am just trying to show you everything that I got. Or I shipped up here in the last couple of months. And like I said, most of this stuff was just erroneous, guys. It's just, I thought that I would need it, so if I thought that I would need it, I would just buy it. It's an extra tool, it's hardware, it's something that I'm eventually going to use. And yeah, I packed the living heck out of this thing. Whether it survived or not, I do not know. We're about to find out together. Found a job for you, Teresa. By the way, there is a lady standing over here. She's just not a part of this video. She has a bikini channel, and you guys can go check her out on that. I'll leave a link in the description below. So, just like a regular cook stove, it's got two burners up top, two BTU burners. It is a propane stove. You hook up to the large cylinders, 100 pound tank, 30 pound tank, whatever. That's what I've got. That's what it'll be powering this. So now cooking in the cabin is going to be fantastic. So I'm going to build a kitchen work surface. I'm going to drop this down into it to where the burners will be just proud of the kitchen surface. Life is going to get a lot better. The main reason I bought this was for the ability of the oven. Glass made it up here. More packing. There's the knobs for it. Once I get this thing up and running, fully functional, I'll go ahead and show you. But more of my supplies were in here too. So, okay, this is one of the cords that comes with it. I bought the 12 footer. This one looks 5 or 6, I believe. Comes with a little thermometer. But here's what I was trying to show you. Baking pans for this little oven. These easily fit in here. These are small guys right there. Bread pans, gotta have them. Got three of these guys. Three loaves of bread, which all three can fit in at the same time. Oven rack. And that's it, guys. That concludes the entire show of all the stuff that I've shipped up here over the last couple months. Like I said, don't have an immediate use for it right now, but there will come a time when all this stuff is going to come in handy. And if you don't have it, you can't use it. So I just kept buying stuff I think that I would need in the future. So I hope you guys enjoyed this long-winded video. I know it's running really long, but this is just all stuff that I've shipped up over the last 4 or 5 months. So I'm glad to have all of it. So until next time, guys, hope you like some of these videos. If not, please leave some comments down below. Let me know what I'm doing good. Let me know what I'm doing wrong. Would love to hear from you guys. Gets a little lonely out here sometimes. So when I can get to a computer and I see comments, I love to read them. I love to respond to all you guys. But that's rare that I can get to a computer. So it's not that I'm ignoring you or any of your comments. It's just sometimes it doesn't always work that way. So thanks for coming along, guys. If you like these videos, if you want to see more of Alaskan bush, like I said, I'm 70 miles out in the middle of nowhere. Would love to have you guys join along, follow me what I'm doing. And I guess I'm going to go ahead and sign out. So everybody keep your boots dry. Hope you're having a great day and love the ones you're with.